Hey guys, just a couple of things to tell before the video starts. First of all, the giveaway is still going on, so make sure you go to my Twitter and follow the steps for the giveaway for a final mouse and the Turtle Beach headset. And second, make sure you join my Discord server. I announce whenever I go live, we announce when our new video is live, and more importantly, we now have Apex channels and Apex looking for group channels. So if you're looking for friends to play with on console or PC, or if you're looking for friends to play very aggressive or very defensive, strategic, high kill games, whatever you want, join the Discord, you can probably find your friends there. All right, enjoy the video. So, I have two leaks. Here's the first one. This one's pog as fuck. His passive... Oh, you can't see. Whatever. Here's the leaked character. His passive is Swift Mend. While not taking damage, Octane restores health over time. Which is fucking good. There's probably like a cooldown, I would guess, from like... When you take damage, and it would like... You know, it would take a while. I would guess that, like, you take damage as a cooldown, so when you're not in combat, it starts, like, slowly regenerating health, which is nice, because you can save a lot of, like, time, and especially meds doing that. It's probably gonna be really, like, slow, but, like, you know, I would say, like, probably 5 seconds out of combat, 10 seconds out of combat. His tactical ability is Adrenaline Junkie. Move 30% faster for 6 seconds, cost 10% health. That's cool. It's cool that they have abilities in a BR game that actually uses your health as a resource. Like, who thought that any character would have a resource cost on any abilities? This is cool. This is really cool. And you could probably chain that movement speed into, like, B-hops and stuff as well. That's cool. I actually really like that ability. And his ultimate, deployable jump pad that catapults users through the air. Dude. That could be so cool. Wait, this is actually good because now, like... It depends on how far up in the air you go, obviously. But, like, you guys have probably ran into teams where, like, there's a Pathfinder who has, like, a really long-distance grappling hook to get up to one specific high point, like, on a wall or, like, something. And you just have, like, teams camping up there, and they just shoot, and then they back off, you know, they heal. This could actually mean, like, you could just place a jump pad and just actually hard engage on it instead of just flying in a straight line on a grappling hook. I really like this. This ability is really cool. And he seems to look really cool as well. He seems to have train wreck strikes though, like fucking chicken legs, as you can see. But and then there's this one. Just like the player, the fucking character select list has a lot of characters. And Octane, which was the previous one, is actually in there too. Jericho, Prophet, Rampart, Rosie, Skunner, Watson, Octane, which is the previous character, Crypto, Husaria, and Nomad. Dude, there are so many characters. And imagine if they just, like, dump them. Like, they just, like, dude, we have 2 character releases every week or something. This is absolutely insane. And it's making me really excited for the future. Because, like, oh, man, this is cool. If I play Nomad, then you literally cannot say that I'm mad, chat. You can't say that I'm mad if I'm playing Nomad. Actually, you cannot. This is cool. This is really cool. And, like, with a really interesting kit like this on Octane, the high-speed Daredevil PogChamp, and you see the Battle Pass up there, so there's a Battle Pass coming. Hell yeah, this is cool. All right, this is cool. 10% current health, and you probably won't be able to kill yourself with it, that's my guess.
Characters haven't even released and you're already trying to exploit them. Stop killing the game, Mendo Mad.
I'm sure that's not exploiting. That's probably just the tech. Like, let's be real. All right, this is the game, boys. I think there's like... Oh, people on me. I think there's like a science behind it. Like, I think you can learn how to aim step by step and a lot of practice. I think people who do it naturally, they just happen to like, you know, they learn it from like trial and error and a lot of experience, you know? I think if you start practicing, you like, you think about when to lift your mouse, when not to lift it, stuff like that. You could probably get better. I don't think you're fucked, XCC, you know, like if you really wanted to. But it would definitely take a long time.
In hearts.
Oh, fuck. I can't believe you've done this.
Now having like very hardcore mechanics.
Yeah, but that's mainly because the population is so low.
Like, oh, yeah, dude, my former classmate, he actually dropped out of school to go pro, and he went pro in hearts. And he told me that literally a monkey could play the game professionally, and like, I understand it. But like, there's not real like mechanical skill required for it.
Yeah.
What was that? I have a tutorial on my YouTube, guys. If you check out my YouTube channel and check the Infinite Flying video, I have a timestamp, a comment in on that video saying, telling you guys like the timestamp, so every tip, trick, and exploit that I'm walking through, and it details that. Take the portals, maybe? And we split. Oh, he's over here. You can portal. There's three players. There's two portals. Take the second one as well.
Please, let me get more than one kill. Okay, took the wrong portal. Sure did.
Dude.
Alright, new challenge. Unbind your W key.
Dude,
100
damage!
Let's go here. Got a good feeling about this area. Maybe even? Yeah, two teams. Throw my grenade out. Frag out. Opening fire. Reloading. Reloading. Am I really about to be Mozambique'd?
Hops from squad.
Easy, they're owning. Yo, thank you so much! Hey, Sitka, bro, how are you? Oh, you can kill him, he's one health. I got him. Kobe! Bro, are you stepping into my thing? Where are you gonna run now, huh? You can't run that way, bro. Oh wait, he can't. He can just go out in the middle. Well, I didn't know I was here. Where is that from? Oh. Armor's low. That sounds good. I've seen a lot of high level people use Wraith. Is that because is that a hitbox thing? She just runs like Naruto. She looks cool as fuck. I think the wingman and most weapons are in a pretty good spot. Some weapons need minor adjustments, and some weapons like Mozambique need a little bit of bigger ones. But overall, I think the wingman would be good after slight adjustments and slight nerfs, like decreasing the range at which the weapon can headshot. So after a certain range, headshots are no longer possible. Nerfing hipfire spread a little bit. In decreasing the extended mag's capacity a little bit, or decreasing the time it takes to aim down sights. Reloading. I downed an enemy. Throwing arc star.
Need to recharge my shields. Reloading. Reloading.
Firing. Da-da-da. I have to reload my Mozambique, dude. There's a Wraith with one health and a lifeline. My lifeline's doing a finisher. Kill the lifeline. She's finishing me. Execute. Okay. Bro! Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Going upstairs? On my body still? He's probably gonna finish me. Yeah.
Already, I got it.
I hit all of them.
Need to recharge my shields.
Yeah, I mean, I dealt damage to them, but yeah, they were definitely low. Oh, sh.
Oh.
Dude, you acted down, Daniel.
Fuck. I tried to door him. Yo, he's right on me.
Oh, no.
Oh, my.
Reloading.
Enemy down. Peacekeeper, he's running right here.
Good.
Is a different team there?
He's right on me. No! Run. Don't let him get you.
What's your name?
Felix, please, give me.
Say, respawn Ryan. Say it. Respawn Ryan.
Down Daniel.
Down Daniel.
Down Daniel, and if you're lucky, respawn Ryan.
Like, Door stuck!
Let's take him on run!
Oh my god, he's low! Dude, down Daniel never gets a kill Kyle!
He had a peacekeeper and I had a f***ing auto pistol. What do you f***ing want from me? Okay, next time, let's all push the same squad.
200 damage! You also had 200 damage!
My shift was ended! I was all in.
Wait, XC, fallen Felix.
That's so funny. On the keyboard like a piñata.
Thank you so much for the subs, guys. Oh my god, fuck, I want that Kraber so bad. Break my new armor, man. Come on. My world record is in most 1v3 solo kills in a game with recorded evidence. There are other world records like 322 solo kills in a screenshot, 56 solo kills in a screenshot, 41 solo kills in a screenshot, and 39 and 41, I think. I'm not sure which one of those are legit, but there's no proof of anything, so. But mine's the highest with recorded evidence. You have 59 kills, but your dog ate the video. Oh, dude, that's so unlucky, man. Do you believe Shroud is an aimbotter? No, he's just... He's a human aimbot. Shroud is a human aimbot.